Hi, John. Have you heard about the new management techniques being implemented in our company?
Yes, I have. Our CEO recently attended a conference on business management and shared some exciting insights with the team.
That's great. Could you give me an example of one of these new techniques?
Sure. One of the concepts he mentioned is servant leadership, where managers focus on supporting their team members and helping them succeed.
That sounds interesting. How does it differ from traditional management styles?
Well, in traditional management, the focus is often on giving orders and expecting employees to follow them. But with servant leadership, managers act as mentors and facilitators.
I see. So, it's about empowering employees and fostering a collaborative work environment?
Exactly. It emphasizes trust, open communication, and valuing the contributions of every team member. It can lead to increased employee engagement and overall productivity.
That's definitely something worth implementing. I believe it could create a positive work culture. Any other noteworthy techniques?
Another one is the Agile methodology, which is widely used in software development. It promotes flexibility, adaptive planning, and iterative improvements.
Interesting. How can we apply Agile methodology outside of software development?
Agile principles can be applied to various projects, not just software. It involves breaking down tasks into smaller, manageable parts and encourages continuous feedback and adaptation.
That sounds like a more efficient approach. It must help teams respond better to changes in the business environment.
Absolutely. It enables teams to be more responsive and adaptable, leading to quicker problem solving and improved customer satisfaction.
I can see how these new management techniques align with our company's goals. It's essential to stay updated and embrace innovative practices.
Definitely. Embracing new approaches to management can give us a competitive edge and create a positive work environment for everyone.
I completely agree. Let's share these insights with our colleagues and discuss how we can implement them in our own teams.
That's a great idea. Together, we can drive positive change and contribute to the growth and success of our company.
Absolutely. Let's make sure our teams are aware of these techniques and provide the necessary support for their implementation. It's an exciting time for our organization.
I couldn't agree more. Let's lead by example and inspire others to embrace these new management practices. Together, we can achieve great things.
I'm thrilled to be part of this journey. Let's get started and make a difference in our workplace.
Hi. I've been reading about the importance of customer service in business management. It's fascinating how it can impact a company's success.
Absolutely. Customer service plays a crucial role in building strong relationships with customers and fostering loyalty. What have you learned?
Well, I've come across the concept of customer centricity. It's about putting the customer at the center of every decision and prioritizing their needs and satisfaction.
That's spot on. By understanding their needs, we can tailor our products and services to meet their expectations, ultimately leading to increased customer loyalty and retention.
Exactly. It's not just about providing a good product. It's about creating a memorable experience that keeps customers coming back and recommending our brand to others.
So true. Good customer service also involves active listening and effective communication. It's important to address any concerns or issues promptly and empathetically.
Absolutely. When customers feel heard and valued, it enhances their overall experience and strengthens their connection with the brand.
I've also read about the concept of going the extra mile in customer service. It means exceeding customer expectations and surprising them with exceptional service.
Going above and beyond can leave a lasting impression on customers. It could be as simple as a handwritten thank you note or personalized recommendations based on their preferences.
Personalization is key. It shows that we truly care about our customers as individuals and not just as another transaction. It fosters a sense of trust and loyalty.
Another aspect of customer service is handling complaints or difficult situations. It's crucial to remain calm, empathetic, and resolve issues promptly and satisfactorily.
Absolutely. By handling complaints effectively, we can turn a negative experience into a positive one, demonstrating our commitment to customer satisfaction.
I've also learned about the importance of training and empowering customer service representatives. They are the front line of our business and need to be equipped with the right skills.
That's right. Training should focus on both technical knowledge and interpersonal skills, such as active listening, problem solving, and maintaining a positive attitude.
It's also essential to have clear guidelines and processes in place for handling different customer scenarios. Consistency is key to delivering a seamless customer service experience.
I agree. Standardizing processes ensures that customers receive the same level of service, regardless of who assists them, creating a sense of reliability and professionalism.
Additionally, collecting and analyzing customer feedback is crucial. It helps us identify areas for improvement and make data-driven decisions to enhance our customer service efforts.
Definitely. Feedback provides valuable insights into what customers love about our service and where we can make improvements. It's a continuous learning process.
I'm glad we're on the same page. Investing in exceptional customer service can set us apart from competitors and build a loyal customer base.
Absolutely. Let's continue to prioritize customer centricity, train our team effectively, and consistently strive to exceed customer expectations. It's the key to our success.
I couldn't agree more. Together, we can create a customer service culture that reflects our commitment to excellence and ensures long-term business growth.
Hi there. Have you started working on our business plan for the upcoming year?
Yes, I have. I think it's crucial to have a well-thought-out plan to guide us towards our goals and ensure our business's success.
Absolutely. What are the key components you're considering in the plan?
Well, I believe we should start with a thorough analysis of our current market position and competitors. It's essential to understand the landscape we're operating in.
That's a good point. By analyzing the market, we can identify opportunities, potential threats, and areas where we can differentiate ourselves from competitors.
Exactly. After the market analysis, we should set clear and measurable objectives. These objectives should be aligned with our overall business strategy and vision.
I agree. Setting specific and achievable goals will help us stay focused and track our progress effectively. What other components do you think we should include?
I think it's important to develop a comprehensive sales and marketing strategy. This should outline our target audience, positioning, pricing, and promotional activities.
A well-defined sales and marketing strategy will guide us in reaching our target customers and effectively promoting our products or services. What about financial planning?
Financial planning is crucial. We should develop a detailed budget, forecasting our expenses and revenues, and ensuring we have a realistic financial outlook for the year.
Absolutely. By having a clear understanding of our financial situation, we can make informed decisions, allocate resources effectively, and plan for growth and profitability.
Another important aspect is creating an organizational structure and defining roles and responsibilities. This will help ensure smooth operations and accountability within the team.
You're right. By clarifying roles and responsibilities, we can improve collaboration, avoid duplication of efforts, and ensure everyone is working towards the same objectives.
Communication and implementation are also vital. We should develop a clear timeline and action plan, assigning tasks to team members and regularly reviewing progress.
Good communication and effective implementation are key to turning our plans into reality. Regularly reviewing our progress will allow us to make necessary adjustments along the way.
That's true. Additionally, we should consider potential risks and develop a risk management plan to mitigate any threats that could impact our business's performance.
Identifying and addressing risks proactively will help us minimize potential disruptions and ensure the continuity of our operations. It's an important aspect of business planning.
Lastly, we should regularly monitor and evaluate our performance against our objectives. This will allow us to identify areas of improvement and make necessary adjustments.
Continuous monitoring and evaluation will help us stay on track and make informed decisions. It ensures that our business plan remains dynamic and adaptable to changes.
Absolutely. By incorporating all these components into our business plan, we can have a clear roadmap for success and increase our chances of achieving our goals.
I completely agree. Let's work together to develop a comprehensive and well-structured business plan that will guide us towards growth and success in the upcoming year.
Sounds like a plan. With our combined efforts and a solid business plan in place, I'm confident that we can overcome challenges and achieve remarkable results.
I've been reading about employment issues in business management. It's essential to address them effectively to create a positive work environment.
Absolutely. What specific employment issues have you come across, and how can we manage them in our organization?
One issue is employee engagement. It's crucial to foster a sense of purpose, provide growth opportunities, and recognize and reward employees' contributions.
I agree. Engaged employees are more motivated and productive. We can promote engagement through regular communication, feedback, and creating a supportive work culture.
Another issue is workplace diversity and inclusion. We should strive to create an environment where everyone feels valued, respected, and represented.
Diversity and inclusion are essential for innovation and better decision-making. We can implement inclusive hiring practices, diversity training, and establish inclusive policies.
Absolutely. Work-life balance is another critical issue. We should promote a healthy balance by encouraging flexible working hours and providing support for personal well-being.
Yes, maintaining work-life balance enhances employee satisfaction and reduces burnout. We can also implement wellness programs and promote a culture of self-care.
Another challenge is managing conflicts in the workplace. It's important to address conflicts promptly and constructively, fostering open communication and conflict resolution skills.
Conflict resolution is crucial for maintaining a harmonious work environment. We can provide training on effective communication and mediation techniques for our employees.
I've also come across the issue of talent retention. It's essential to create a supportive and inclusive culture that encourages professional growth and development.
Retaining top talent is key to our success. We can implement mentorship programs, offer career development opportunities, and provide competitive compensation and benefits.
Absolutely. Employee morale is another aspect to consider. Regular recognition, team-building activities, and creating a positive work atmosphere can boost morale.
Positive morale contributes to a motivated and engaged workforce. We can encourage teamwork, celebrate achievements, and foster a culture of appreciation and collaboration.
Another issue is managing remote or hybrid teams. We should provide the necessary tools and support for effective communication, collaboration, and productivity.
Remote work is becoming increasingly prevalent. By implementing remote work policies, ensuring clear expectations, and leveraging technology, we can enable remote teams to thrive.
Lastly, mental health awareness is a critical issue. We should prioritize employee well-being and provide resources for mental health support and stress management.
Mental health should be a priority. We can organize workshops, offer counseling services, and create a stigma-free environment for employees to seek help if needed.
Addressing these employment issues requires a comprehensive approach. By focusing on employee engagement, diversity, work-life balance, conflict resolution, talent retention, morale, remote work, and mental health, we can create a positive and productive work environment.
I completely agree. Let's take these issues seriously and implement strategies to address them. By prioritizing our employees' well-being, we can achieve long-term success and foster a thriving organization.
I've been researching financial management in business. It's crucial to have a solid understanding of financial principles to make informed decisions and ensure profitability.
Absolutely. What specific areas of financial management have you been exploring, and how can we apply them to our business?
One area is budgeting. It's important to develop a realistic budget that aligns with our goals and accounts for expenses, revenue projections, and financial contingencies.
I agree. A well-planned budget helps us allocate resources effectively and make strategic decisions. It ensures we have the necessary funds for operations and growth.
Another aspect is financial analysis. By analyzing our financial statements, we can assess our performance, identify trends, and make data-driven decisions.
Financial analysis provides valuable insights into our profitability, liquidity, and solvency. It allows us to assess the health of our business and identify areas for improvement.
Cash flow management is also crucial. We need to monitor and manage our cash inflows and outflows to ensure we have sufficient liquidity to meet our obligations.
That's right. Proper cash flow management ensures we can pay our bills, meet payroll, and invest in growth opportunities. It's the lifeblood of our business.
Risk management is another important aspect.
We should identify potential risks and develop strategies to mitigate them, protecting our financial stability and reputation.
Mitigating risks minimizes potential financial losses and safeguards our business. We can implement risk assessment processes and have contingency plans in place.
Absolutely. Another area is investment analysis. We should evaluate potential investments, considering factors such as return on investment and risk levels.
Making informed investment decisions can help us generate additional income and grow our business. We can conduct thorough analysis and assess the potential risks and rewards.
Tax planning is also critical. We should have a clear understanding of our tax obligations and explore strategies to minimize tax liabilities within legal boundaries.
Effective tax planning ensures we comply with tax regulations and optimize our tax position. Consulting with tax experts can help us navigate complex tax laws.
Lastly, financial reporting is vital. We should prepare accurate and timely financial reports, including income statements, balance sheets, and cash flow statements.
Financial reporting provides transparency and accountability. It allows us to communicate our financial performance to stakeholders, such as investors and lenders.
By implementing these financial management practices, we can ensure financial stability, make informed decisions, and position our business for long-term success.
I completely agree. Let's prioritize financial management and apply these principles to our business. It will enable us to drive profitability, manage risks, and make sound financial decisions.
Definitely. With a strong financial foundation, we can navigate challenges, seize opportunities, and achieve our business objectives. Let's stay proactive and committed to financial management. I've been studying inventory control in business management. It's crucial to manage our inventory effectively to optimize costs, minimize inventory outage, and meet customer demands.
Absolutely. What specific strategies have you come across, and how can we implement them in our business?
One strategy is implementing a just-in-time inventory system. It involves keeping inventory levels minimal and ordering materials or products only when needed.
Just-in-time inventory system can help us reduce carrying costs and minimize waste. By having inventory arrive just in time for production or customer orders, we can improve efficiency and cash flow.
Another approach is ABC analysis, where we categorize inventory items based on their value and prioritize management efforts accordingly.
That's a good idea. By focusing on high-value items, we can ensure they are always available and properly managed, while reducing attention on lower-value items.
Another concept is safety stock. It involves maintaining a buffer of inventory to account for unexpected increases in demand or supply chain disruptions.
Safety stock can prevent inventory shortage and ensure we meet customer demands even in unpredictable situations. It's important to strike a balance to avoid excess inventory.
Lead time management is also critical. It refers to the time it takes from placing an order to receiving it. By reducing lead times, we can minimize inventory levels.
Streamlining our supply chain and building strong relationships with suppliers can help us reduce lead times and have inventory arrive faster, enhancing efficiency.
Another strategy is implementing effective demand forecasting. By accurately predicting customer demand, we can adjust our inventory levels accordingly, avoiding shortages or excess.
Demand forecasting allows us to align our inventory with customer needs. we can utilize historical data, market trends, and customer insights to improve our forecasting accuracy.
Just as important is implementing proper inventory tracking and management systems. This can help us monitor stock levels, track sales, and identify slow-moving or obsolete items.
With accurate inventory data, we can make informed decisions, identify trends, and take action to optimize our inventory levels, reducing carrying costs and maximizing sales.
Absolutely. We should also consider adopting technology solutions like barcode systems or inventory management software to streamline our inventory control processes.
Automation can enhance accuracy and efficiency. Technology solutions can help us track inventory in real time, generate reports, and streamline order fulfillment processes.
Lastly, regular inventory audits are crucial. By conducting periodic physical counts and reconciling them with our records, we can identify discrepancies and take corrective actions.
Inventory audits ensure the accuracy of our inventory data and help us identify any issues, such as theft or errors. It's an essential practice for effective inventory control.
By implementing these inventory control strategies, we can optimize our inventory levels, reduce costs, improve customer satisfaction, and streamline our operations.
I completely agree. Let's apply these strategies to our inventory management practices. It will enable us to achieve better control, maximize efficiency, and drive business success.
Definitely. With effective inventory control, we can meet customer demands promptly, minimize inventory outage, and maintain a healthy cash flow. Let's make inventory management a priority.
I've been studying risk management in business. It's crucial to identify and mitigate risks to protect our business and ensure long-term success.
Absolutely. What specific areas of risk management have you been exploring, and how can we apply them to our business?
One area is risk assessment. We need to identify potential risks that could impact our business, evaluate their likelihood and potential impact, and develop strategies to manage them.
Risk assessment allows us to be proactive and address risks before they escalate. By understanding the potential consequences, we can prioritize our risk management efforts.
Another aspect is risk mitigation. We should develop strategies to minimize the likelihood and impact of identified risks.
Mitigating risks involves implementing controls, safeguards, or contingency plans to reduce the likelihood of occurrence or minimize the potential damage if they do occur.
Another concept is risk transfer. We can transfer certain risks to external parties, such as insurance companies, through appropriate insurance coverage.
Risk transfer allows us to shift the financial burden of certain risks to insurance providers, giving us peace of mind and protecting our business from significant financial losses.
Another strategy is diversification. By diversifying our products, markets, or investments, we can reduce our exposure to specific risks.
Diversification spreads our risk across different areas, minimizing the impact if one area faces difficulties. It helps us maintain stability and adapt to changing circumstances.
Another aspect is contingency planning. We should develop plans to respond to unforeseen events and minimize the disruption they may cause.
Contingency planning ensures that we have predefined actions and resources in place to address emergencies or unexpected situations effectively.
Additionally, we should consider business continuity planning. This involves creating strategies to ensure our business can continue operating during disruptions.
Business continuity planning enables us to keep our operations running and serve our customers even during challenging times. It helps maintain customer trust and minimizes financial losses.
Lastly, we should emphasize a risk-aware culture within our organization. It involves promoting risk awareness and encouraging employees to identify and report potential risks.
A risk-aware culture fosters a proactive approach to risk management. By involving all employees, we can harness their collective knowledge to identify and address risks effectively.
By implementing these risk management practices, we can protect our business, minimize financial losses, and ensure a resilient and sustainable operation.
I completely agree. Let's prioritize risk management and apply these principles to our business. It will enable us to navigate uncertainties, seize opportunities, and achieve long-term success.
Definitely. With a robust risk management framework, we can identify, assess, and mitigate risks proactively. Let's foster a culture of risk awareness and keep our business resilient.
Absolutely. Risk management is an ongoing process that requires continuous evaluation and adaptation. Let's stay vigilant and committed to managing risks effectively.